Uganda's capital, Kampala, is one of Africa's most progressive and vibrant cities. Since the current president's coming to power in 1985, the south of the country has undergone an economic transformation. Business is booming like never before, and achievements in education have won applause from the international community. Despite its violent post-independence history, Kampala is seen as one of the safest capitals in Africa, and tourism has flourished. Yet throughout Uganda's recent renaissance, the most easterly region, Karamoja, has been plagued by armed conflict and has some of the worst development indicators in the world. It is a land where tens of thousands have been killed in violent cattle raids and into tribal wars. Karamoja is an area roughly the same size as Belgium, situated along Uganda's border with Kenya. The Karamojong, who inhabit this region, are a herd of people who have traditionally led a semi-nomadic lifestyle. They are divided between clans, of which the largest are the Bakora, Jie, Mathaniko and Dodoth tribes. These rival tribes have frequently gone to war with each other over cows and grazing grounds. Karamojong culture has been greatly eroded over the last 50 years. This is due to a very gradual transition to modernity and the effects that modern weapons have had on society. Despite this, Karamojong traditions are still important, especially their cultural obsession with cattle. They are seen as a backward people by most Ugandans, and the Ugandan saying, "We cannot wait for Karamoja," signifies that the Karamojong are a burden to their country. Burden or not, the Karamojong have certainly been troublesome for their neighbouring regions. The Eteso people have been particularly badly affected by the Karamojong. The lands of the Eteso border the Karamojong frontier. The Eteso are a pastoralist people who share a common heritage with the Karamojong. Having abandoned nomadic pastoral life and adopted Western clothes, the Eteso are held with little regard by the Karamojong, who have raided them profusely for decades. As well as this, they have had to suffer the threat of the Lord's Resistance Army, a particularly sadistic rebel movement. Many Eteso have been forced to move to internally displaced people's camps, like this one seen from the air. This is Kapalebion, an internally displaced people's camp with a population of 6,000. Many have been here since the 1970s, when the camp was first set up. Esther, who is a new arrival to the camp, has had to endure more than most. Her first husband was killed during an attack by the Lord's Resistance Army, and more recently, her village was raided by Karamojong warriors. She explained to me what happened when the Karamojongs attacked her community.
So the Karamojong warriors, they came to our place. So when they came, they found me inside there mingling. My posho was staying with my two small children. So after that, they came, everybody was carrying a gun. So they came to me, the door was opened, So everybody was trying to shoot me with a gun. There were very many of them. They pushed me and said, "You come out. Where's the money? We want money." He said, "No money." He said, "We want cows." I said, "Ah, I don't have cows. Where's your husband?" I said, "No husband. I don't have husband here." He said, "You come out." They pulled me outside. So they told me that, "Now, we want your dress." So I said, "No, you people, you let me put my child down." Then I laid my child down. I raised up my hands to get up the dress. So they carried the dress. Some of them entered inside. So I remained with it, only half paid. They said, "You get that one also. We want that one." They said, "Now you are going to make me naked." So I get the half paid and gave them. So I just sat down and get my child. So one of them said, "Ah, no, now we want to beat you." One of them said, "No, we have taken everything of this lady. Now you want to beat this lady. Let's go." There were very many of them, like 100 people like that. All of them were carrying guns. So after that, I ran and slept in the bush with my two children. All of us were naked up to morning.
Kapalebiong, like most IDP camps, is severely lacking in facilities. Poor management of the camp has meant that funds are allocated badly. The camp clinic, for example, appears to be receiving some attention to its exterior, while inside there are no doctors, no beds, and the floor is strewn with discarded medicine. Few medical staff have come here for fear of the insecurity and because of the poor standard of living that the camp has to offer.
Are most of these children, are they in school?
Some of them, but education is really poor. Education is really poor.
Very few teachers.
Teachers fear this place because when somebody is posted here because of the insurgency, people fear. They don't report on time.
So is that the same with the hospital also?
Yeah.
For the doctors, they don't?
Actually, we don't have even a senior doctor here.
And there are, for these 5,000 people in the camp, there is no senior doctor?
No.
Is there any doctor staying in the camp at all?
We have only one clinical officer who is just trying to help.
And he's not even a trained doctor?
No. It's just a medical assistant.
How often do you have a trained doctor here?
We need him.
But how often does a doctor from town come here?
It's a bit. Yeah, it has taken some time. We had one. I think that was around 2000. But he feared the situation and he went back.
The camp is protected by a group of militia known as the Arrow Boys. Although they have been effective in fighting the Karamojong in the past, they provide poor security for the people of this camp. Many complain that the militia are often drunk and even responsible for acts of theft and rape.